I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. No trespassing? No way. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed. Nothing says badass like a nice floral print. I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
I should slap those.
Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
I understand, really, and it won't ever happen again.
This RV's just begging for a little street art. But if I do it here, someone will see me.
Trust with me is earned in action.
Ah, perfect place for me to work. Now what to draw? Hey, kids! Free candy. Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show. This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere, miles from home. Home. Right. Now I remember why I'm here. Any place is better than home.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
God, again? What do you want, kid?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Don't sleep. It's for the weak.
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Bosses suck. Screw the man and fuck the rules, dude.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. What's her name?
Delia. She doesn't usually like people.
Yeah. Me neither. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show. Don't mess with Damon. Thanks for the memo. Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey. Yo, Frank!
Hey!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup, studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm here to see Firewalk, man. They rock.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
So, you... come here a lot, or...?
Yeah.
Right. It's cool.
I'm really glad you approve.
Okay, so, you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye. How about you spot me some? You know I'm good for it.
No way. I learned my lesson last time. Money first.
Never mind, then.
Suit yourself.
No thanks. I try to avoid hepatitis when I can. Classy. Reminds me of the way I make important life choices. How can you just chill when Firewalk is tearing it up in the next room?
All right, it's not gonna take any more than an hour.
Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday.
Okay, good. That's exactly what we need. Thank you. Yeah, I mean...
Hey, are you selling
20
any...
20 bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dick.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I've explained it to you. Hey, I told you 20 bucks. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative. Yeah, no shit. This car could slide down any minute. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, Dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like 200 bucks. Holy shit, I'm rich. Nothing sadder than a neglected bong.
She returns.
About that weed.
Here it comes.
Toss in a dime bag and we'll call it square.
Hey, what are you waving around this kind of money here for? You really don't think before you act, do you?
Nope. So where's my pot?
No more loans. I'm not your fucking piggy bank.
You're a good man, Frank.
No. I'm not. Now beat it, Price. You're cramping my style.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Feel less. Yes, please. Sit and spit. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above. Made it! I can't believe it!
Yeah.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Rolling! Wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. The skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? Smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. I bet Long Max Silver traded her hat for beer and booty long ago.
Terrible news, my fellow Oregonians. Our very own Pacific Steve's famous crab is shutting its doors. Might have something to do with all the health and safety violations they've suffered this year. You've had a near-death experience eating there.
Can't leave without my vitamins. I really should get going. Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast. Better living through chemistry. That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings. Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. Fun fact, shark babies eat their siblings in the womb. Maybe that's why I'm an only child. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now. Just ask Steve Jobs. Shit, where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay, Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to. Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie. Better. It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money. Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair is his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner. I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
What's the matter, Mom? You don't want Dad to see your new boyfriend?
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone, too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pond. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. We're already supporting one. Thanks. Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never-
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max?
And never looked back? Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school? From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault. Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist. Wait, those aren't Mom's keys. And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe? Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? Shoot. I was hoping David could get a job on a container ship. To Japan. Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewalk? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I better get going. I actually have to let this jack-off drive me to school. This is my life now. Kill me.
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us. No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites the
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Should fill this with gasoline just in case David's car ever catches on fire. Damn, the stereo used to be in Dad's workshop. I should hook it up in my room before garbage day gets it first. Dad's old camera. Do they even make film for these anymore? Uh-oh. Mom's been cleaning again. This was the photo Mom took down from the living room. Guess we don't have room for it and David's mustache. David's lawnmower. Maybe Mom and I like our lawn the way it is. Ever think of that? Dad's toolbox. He used to get so excited whenever anything sprung a leak or busted. Do these have chapters on hotwiring your mom's boyfriend's car so you can drive it off a cliff? Asking for... ...50-50 chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10.
A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine, whatever. Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me?
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my friend. What a beautiful day. This isn't right. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
Car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
People can eat a dick. Even social media haters can't ruin how awesome last night was.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. Maybe this play won't suck. Maybe. How could I possibly make it through a day in this place without a little chemical assistance? Meh. Well, at least not for now. Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
So, I went to the mill last night. Caught Firewalk live.
Yeah, I can see that. Wait, you went to the mill last night?
It was cool.
Whoa, pretty wicked. I didn't know you were into music like that.
What? Like good music?
Preach it, sister. I'm in a band, actually.
No shit. Really?
We're called Pisshead. It's not a big deal or anything. I mean, I'm trying to get our demo out there, but it's hard.
Pisshead, huh?
Would you maybe want to hear it? Our demo, I mean.
Yeah, okay.
Great. What did you think?
That was really good, man. If Pisshead came on the radio, I'd turn that shit up.
Oh, right on. Awesome, Chloe, thanks.
Morning, Miss Grant.
What do you think of this hypothesis? That you'll be in your seat by the time chemistry class begins today.
I wouldn't miss it for all the manganese in the world, Miss Grant.
Your sincerity's overwhelming. With all the change that's happening at Blackwell of late, I suppose I can appreciate your consistent wit, Chloe.
What kind of change do you mean?
Well, the Prescotts have made an extremely generous donation to the school, which is good, but instead of going to support more science and mathematics, it's all being dedicated to the arts.
You don't think more money should be spent in the arts?
It's not that exactly. I recently made the case that STEM programs should receive more support, but apparently our new donors disagree with me. Such is life, I suppose.
Miss Grant actually seems sad. Look at it this way, Miss Grant. More art classes will keep all the smug, self-absorbed types out of your science classroom.
Articulate, as always.
I should probably be getting to class, but I just don't care. Did last night really happen? The internet says it did, but I still can't believe it. Rachel Amber. The drama star, honor student, popular princess of Blackwell. Swoops in like a Batman to save my ass and thrash to firewalk? Either that was a dream, or real life just got a shit ton crazier.
Principal Wells. Hey.
Stay cool, Chloe. You've got a marijuana-flavored bag of expulsion in your pocket.
Miss Price. The sign clearly says, do not walk on the stage. Such disregard for your fellow students' efforts won't alleviate your record of major infractions.
I swear to you, I did not walk on that stage. It was more of a saunter.
Do I look amused to you?
I don't know. I've only seen you with one expression. That's the one.
Perhaps you will find me less amusing if I mention the various allegations I've been hearing about your drug use. You know Blackwell has a zero-tolerance policy. And yet if my olfactory sense does not fail me, I'd say you've recently been exposed to marijuana smoke.
Shit.
Do I have to initiate a search of your person in order to establish the veracity of these allegations, Miss Price? That's what I thought. I'll look forward to seeing you in my office after school today. How does that sound?
All right, sir. I'll see you after school.
I'll count the minutes.
That guy's a tool. Need my DVD from Steph. I bet she's nerding it up with Mikey somewhere.
Hey, Chloe.
Hey, Samantha. What are you reading?
Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
I read that last year in Mrs. Hoyta's English class.
I didn't think you did homework.
Normally I don't, but the play was actually good.
What did you like about it?
It's funny. The title's actually a play on the song, Who's Afraid of the Big Bad Wolf?
And that's funny?
It is if you're the wolf.
I'm not sure if you're joking. Sorry, I'm a little slow sometimes.
I'm a little bitchy sometimes, so it's cool.
People always say that. But I think you're actually... Sorry, Chloe. No one says anything like that. I don't know what I'm actually talking about.
I bet.
Ah, Carrie Price!
It's Chloe.
Oh, right. I'm just teasing. People have been taking me so seriously since I won the Beacon's Young Artist Award for my photography.
You don't say.
Between that and the Vortex Club, it's hard to keep people from putting me up on a pedestal or whatever. But you know all about that. What with Rachel Amber? Am I right?
You hang with the Vortex Club?
I mean, I'm technically not a member, but I am being courted.
I'm not sure
The club should be a collection of Blackwell elites. But instead, it's some anti-bullying, hand-holding kumbaya shit. Not when I'm a senior.
Wow, the Young Artist Award.
Oh, it's not a big deal or anything. Like, 100 people submitted work, and my photography won.
Congrats, I guess.
So the Beacon's putting me up on the front page of the lifestyle section. Who cares?
Wait. What about Rachel Amber?
Rachel posted a slamming selfie of you two having the time of your lives. Do tell.
Tell what, Victoria? It's a photo. Big deal.
But it's on Facebook! I mean, that basically means you and Rachel are like BFFs.
We're really not.
So, what's she into? You know, what's her thing? Is it drugs? I'm not judging or anything. I figure if she's hanging out with you, she must be into some effed up shit. You know?
Seriously, I don't know why you're talking to me about Rachel.
Oh, everybody loves her. Little Miss Perfect.
So you're jealous of Rachel Amber. That's what's happening right now. Gotcha.
Oh, God, I don't have time for this. I didn't even finish the chemistry assignment, and you're being you. Oh. Why would Rachel Amber ever hang out with Carrie Price?
It's Chloe.
Hey, price check. Gotten in any good trouble lately?
Last night, I scoped out this crazy party at the old mill up north. Kind of a DIY thing.
Wow, no shit. I thought that place was like meth central. My cousin met this hooker there.
Whatever. It was cool, okay? You wouldn't understand. Hey, out of the blue question, what do you think of Rachel Amber?
She is amazing. If you're into chicks that are hot, smart, and hot. I mean, she helped me out a while back. I was failing algebra hard.
I believe you.
Check it. After I bombed my midterm last fall, she tutored me for the rest of the semester. And then I crushed it. C+.
All right. Guess I'll see you in class.
Word.
Chloe, I'd like to talk to you about wildfire awareness and prevention.
Good morning to you too, Evan.
According to the Department of Forestry, over 90% of this season's fires were caused by humans. That's a record high and completely preventable.
Who says we should prevent fire? Fire is awesome.
While I realize you're being purposefully obstructive, you raise a good point. Many parts of our local ecosystem benefit from fire. Knobcone pine cones, for example, which require temperatures above 350 degrees to open.
Say knobcone again.
No.
This is for college, right? I don't believe you actually care about this.
My interest in fire prevention is completely sincere. Besides, I intend to get into college on the strength of my photography alone. Do you think Rachel Amber would be willing to pose for my portfolio? She's so artistic. I bet she would be a dream model. What do you think?
I guess. I gotta run.
Wait, one last thing. Will you sign my petition to have a fire safety assembly at school?
Sure. I love assemblies. Some of the best naps of my life.
Wow, thanks. I did not see that coming. You being, you know, interested in complicated issues, helping out with the public.
Do you want me to change my mind?
No.
How seriously am I taking this right now? There you go.
Just don't expect this to become a habit.
Blackwell Academy, home of tomorrow's leaders.
What? Caring about important issues?
Caring in general.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
I used to play with my friend Max. It's been a long time, though.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet.
$5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamah, Wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernum.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes...
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the Durr dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
Guess it's time to free some peeps. Let's go to the prison camp.
You behold a field of standing iron cages, each imprisoning a human villager, calling out for you to free them. Only a small, elderly dragonkin is keeping watch. He notices you, and in terror, runs into one of the few empty cages and locks himself in.
Ah, poor little guy. What's a dragonkin?
Dragonkin are like little dragon people. They're assholes. I bet he has all the keys.
Oh, okay. Hey, shitface! Get out of there!
The dragonkin hops up and down, shaking his ring of keys at you. He shouts in a strange language. Whatever he's saying probably isn't flattering.
Got any useful spells in that robe of yours?
Nothing that wouldn't blow up the cage and everything in it.
Intimidate. That's a skill I have. Can I do that? I want the little bastard to shit his pants.
You can try. What do you say?
Listen up, you little lizard.
Unfortunately, he doesn't speak common, which means he can't-
I cast communication on the dragonkin.
Shit. Really?
Now he can understand every word you say.
Time to work some real magic.
So this is called a skill challenge, where you try to use...
Oh, I know what this is. I grab the bars of the cage and lean in, nice and close.
He steps back, his scaly skin quivering in fear. What do you say?
I wiggle my hand. Hey, Dragon King guy. Want to become my meat puppet? How it works is I shove my arm up your ass into your head, and then I can control your mouth from the inside to say things.
He doesn't seem to like that idea.
Neither do I.
The Dragon King pleads with you. Please don't harm me, tall one. But I cannot give you key. Durgaron, much taller and meaner than you.
You're short, I say. But I could fix that. I'll just cut off your head and wear it as a top hat. Then you'd be way taller.
The Dragon King cowers before you, looking left and right. He opens his jaws and you think he's about to yell for help.
I interrupt his yell by shoving my axe into the cage, pinning his head to the bars without hurting him. Then I say the following.
This is going to be good.
Here's what's up. I'm going to carve the skin from your bones. Then I'm going to turn your skin into a little leather handbag that I'll shove your skinless body into so I can carry it around with me wherever I go. That way, the next time some asshat refuses to give me a key I want, I can pull your body out and show them what happens. How does that sound?
Wow.
That was nuts.
I'm going to give you a +10 bonus to charisma. Go ahead and roll. A small pool of urine collects under the elderly dragonkin as, hands trembling, it hands you the keys. Then it dies of fear.
Awesome.
Yeah!
Go team! Why don't you start unlocking the prisoners?
I'm on it.
As you free them, the prisoners run away from you in fear. What's next?
It's tent time.
Wait! Have you forgotten the training camp? There's potential loot there.
Skip it. I'm craving Warlord steak.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, Warlord of the Raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah, ha, 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Calamastia? What'll it be?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
I want to punch that stupid man cow in the dick.
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Durgaron burst out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
1?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, three.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural. Severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elamon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I do? I jump in front of Elamon.
Wow. Thanks, Chloe. I mean, thanks, Calamastia.
Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgaron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgaron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do you do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant!
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgaron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon!
Durgaron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
What have you got here, Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa, whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
Congrats. You've actually got me feeling sorry for Arcadia Bay's most spoiled brat. That's how much of an asshole you're being right now.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
Please. Kicking your ass is going to be a piece of cake.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat.
You shut the fuck up.
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip. I would sacrifice a goat to Jeremiah Blackwell himself if it meant I'd be leaving here in a month.
Oh, good. You're here.